Hey traders, Raghee here, and in this free video, we're gonna crack open the XLK because there are days where there are buying opportunities in the NASDAQ, but that the QQQs may not be the best example. Probably the worst culprit dragging down the QQQ right now is Amazon. And one very easy way to circumnavigate Amazon and still play tech is to look at the XLK. So this morning we did a session of live trading in the what we call the tops. It's a market bias, market trend class we did, and one of the live trades in the class was Visa. So I'm going to walk through that trade with you right now and talk about what happened on the 1 minute chart. Now Visa overall has been a little choppy, so it's a really good choice to focus on the 1 minute chart in a market that may not have the kind of directional bias and the sort of directional clarity that on the daily, you shorten the time frame and look for clarity that way. So Visa this morning did one of the things we look to see on any index futures, but also on stocks heavily weighted within the index futures and heavily weighted within their sectors, or you know, that will move in a way that is related to that broader average, hence the XLK QQQ connection. So here we have the breach right there, and that's when this automated tool that we make available to members. And by the way, this isn't any kind of high level hocus pocus. Let me just tell you what this is. Between 9:30 and 10, we put in a high and low range during what's known as the clearing. When we breach that level, this particular tool let us know that either the 9:30 to 10 o'clock high was broken or the 9:30 to 10 o'clock low. So what we do is we automate a lot of very simple routine processes that I have been doing for many, many years, in some cases decades, and we just automate it. So it's one less thing for traders to have to remember, for traders to have to watch. It just automates very simply some powerful things. So this opens the door to a buy. Now remember, XLK has a lot of different stocks within it, but it was Visa that created this trigger, and it was Visa that had this very nice clarity moving higher. So we did what? We stepped in and we bought this pullback. And that's exactly what we did going into 11 o'clock. And so when I'm day trading, my time frame is basically a 1 minute time frame, and my time horizon is about 1 hour, which takes me from 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock. So time frame is 1 minute, time horizon is 1 hour. So that's a really quick little trade that we put on. We look for at the money calls. We just ride it up higher to different Darvis levels that have appeared and major psychological levels like 175. But I bring this up in the free video because I think a lot of traders think that if you trade futures, it's all about corn and wheat. And we're going to talk about a lot of those markets, corn, cocoa, wheat, sugar, what's happening with soybeans, as well as what's happening with energies, metals, and the broader index averages. But when you understand what's happening in the broader averages and you can break down to the individual sectors and the individual stocks, it gives you opportunity to take advantage of moves that I believe you wouldn't otherwise consider or see if you were a futures trader. And for me, I want my futures traders as comfortable with Visa as they may be looking at, for example, soybeans. I mean, to me, it really should be that simple. And while it may not be a day trade on soybeans, of course, you sure could. While it may not be a day trade on soybeans, you could certainly look at the market structure and play the end of day chart as well. And by the way, a pullback into the wave, this is not a great example, but it's the same idea. Whether it's a 1 minute or a 1 day chart, it's the same example. So those are things that I really want to express during these free videos, that it isn't just about stock trading or options trading or futures trading, but it's about psychology and market structure and picking the best in breed for what it is that you're looking for, whether it be a day trade buy or short or an end of day buy or short. Hope this helps, and I'll see you in the next update.